Good morning, my dear friends. Today, let us deepen our Christian understanding of death. Should we welcome it like Paul and his famous words, "O death, where is thy sting?" Or should we fear it? Come, join us. Let us reflect on some images of death. Death. Science teaches us death is the expiration of life. We may say that it is a natural event for living creatures, as the book of Ecclesiastes says, "There is an appointed time for everything, and there is a time for every event under heaven, a time to give birth and a time to die." However, Scripture also teaches us that death is a form of sleeping. It is a rest, and it is a reunion. Friends, I wonder how many of us can really share Paul's desire for death. He says, "I desire to depart and be with Christ." We are often so attached to life that we don't want to leave our families and friends, especially when we are unsure of what's next or where we are heading to. Who can blame us? Even the psalmist expressed his fear. He trembled, actually, by saying, "My heart is in anguish within me, and the terrors of death have fallen upon me." But even though we are more on the side of the psalmist and less on the side of Paul, the entirety of the Bible allows us to face death with calmness and hopefulness. Dead people are symbolically described in the Bible as those who sleep in the dust of the earth and those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. But why does the Bible writers use the term sleep instead of saying plainly die? It is because beyond death, a promise lies. Those who have fallen asleep will awake. Those who died will rise soon in the day of the Lord. Comforting, isn't it? Aba, hindi lang pala parang natutulog lamang ang masasabi natin sa isang taong namayapa. Masasabi pala nating talaga na siya o sila ay nahimbing, mahimbing na natutulog lamang. Now, aside from falling asleep and the promise to rise with the Lord, we are taught that death is also rest. But rest from what? Oh, from the hustle and bustle and anxieties of the world. Tama rin pala yung kadalasang sinasabi, ika nga, magpahinga ka na, sapagkat bagamat sila yayao, hindi na natin sila makakapiling dito sa mundo, sila naman po ay makatatanggap ng kapahingahan. To this, we recall the voice in the book of Revelation that says, "Blessed are the dead, that they may rest from their labors." Wow, can you imagine? Many fear death, but a line from Scripture tells us, "Blessed are the dead." Now, we move on to another concern. Where am I going after death? Our faith tells us that when a person dies, he moves to another realm. It is a journey. And we said in our feature, The End Times, some go to heaven, some to purgatory or to hell, depending on a person's ways of life here on earth. The choice is ours. That's why we are constantly reminded to always do the good and all that is pleasing to God. Alam ho ninyo, tayong lahat ay ninanais ng Diyos na makasama niya sa langit. Ngunit dapat nating tanggapin ang pagmamahal niya sa ating salita at gawa. The Apostle Paul consoles us, "No eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor the heart of man imagined what God has prepared for those who love Him." The final Christian image is that of a reunion. When we die, we are to be reunited with our departed loved ones and most especially with Christ. Di ba ho, ito naman talaga ang ating dalangin, ang makasama, ang makapiling ang Diyos sa kanyang kaharian. We recall Jesus' assuring words to the repentant thief, "Today, you will be with me in paradise." Friends, we hope that we have helped you today in facing the reality of death. Let us remember that for us Christians, death is not the end or loss of life, but the entry into eternal life. By dying and rising from the dead, Christ has transformed death. At isang huling paalaala, hindi man natin mapaghahandaan kung kailan natin lilisanin ang buhay sa mundo, maaari naman nating paghandaan ang ating pagtungo sa langit. And that's a better thought to focus on. Till our next meeting, may the good Lord bless us all.